Hey,
everybody smile.
תודה לשם. כולם יגידו תודה.
Everybody say thank you.
תודה רבה לך, הקדוש ברוך הוא. תודה. תודה שאתה מפגיש אותנו. תודה לך, בורא העולם.
Thank you, Creator, to bring us all together.
יוסף נחמה יקר. אחרי הקלעים עושה... מושך בחוטים. תודה רבה, תודה רבה. השתבח שמו לעד.
May his name be blessed. Bring us all together. There's a Moroccan that traveled to America. And he writes to
us. Yes, is a trufa, is a tipot.
He writes home and says there's a medicine that you drink in America and that gets you young. And so his father writes it. He says, look for me, look for this medicine for me. And then he found the medicine. And he wrote back to his parents that has directions how to take the medicine. One drop, you become 10 years younger. Two drops, you're not supposed to drink any more than two drops. A couple of months later, he comes back to Israel, and he gets off at the... He gets off the plane, and a young woman meets him with a baby in her arms, and says, my son, where are you? He says, who are you? She says, I'm your mother. And so he goes on, he ignores her. She says, but my son, stop. Come, talk to me. He says, I understand that the drops made you young, but what about the baby? He says, your father drank the whole bottle. With the Creator's loving grace.
Baruch Hashem, באמת, תודה לשם שזכינו לבוא. אתמול זכינו היה ממש...
We thank the Creator, a privilege of being here with you. Last night, we had a big convention. People were... a lot of spiritual awakening.
תודה לשם שפגיש אותנו...
And I request from the Creator, the King of the world, that he gives us the words that we all need to hear, that we can get closer to him, we can spiritually arouse ourselves. When he wanted to make the world, and he said, what, do you
want to...
The world looks like it's bad because you're far away from faith. So if a person doesn't have faith, he sees bad. But if a person receives emuna, he sees that everything is wonderful. First of all, you have to look at your own life, your own private self, because every person is a world. You have to look at your own private world, the beautiful life that you have. And if you don't see the beautiful life, it means that you lack faith, emunah. A person who believes, he doesn't see any bad in the world. So how can you say that a person who believes doesn't see a bad world? One person doesn't have children. One person doesn't have a soulmate. One person doesn't have good health. One person is crippled. What you can say, he doesn't have deficiencies. How can you say there's no bad in the world? How can you say there's no deficiency in the world? Because the believer believes that the Creator saw that this particular individual cannot attain his spiritual correction, can't perform his mission on earth without this particular deficiency. So the deficiency turns into an advantage. If the Creator understood that a person can't attain his mission on earth without this particular deficiency, then he realized that the deficiency is actually an advantage. So whatever deficiency you have, first of all, say thank you. Because the particular situation that the Creator puts you in, this is the best situation for you to be in. Last year when I was here, I wrote a book that I said thank you and I saw salvation. It's a new book. It's out in Hebrew and we're now translating in English. It's got 190 stories. All the time I meet people that say, you changed my life, you bettered my life. What happened? What's the big change? They got emunah, they had faith. They received faith that they didn't have before. So you have to understand, even if a person prays, he can pray, but he doesn't have necessarily have faith. What kind of faith does he lack? He lacks the faith that whatever the Creator did with him up to now was the best thing for him in his life. If you don't say thank you to the Creator, then you lack faith. And emunah is the spiritual vessel that enables you to receive abundance from above. So whatever you're lacking is really it's a lack of emunah. And why doesn't the Creator give you what you want? Because you don't have a vessel for this abundance. So a person has to understand that if the Creator, for example, doesn't give me my soulmate up till now, when a person says thank you, okay, in the meanwhile, I read the one book and I have to read another one because 190 stories, new stories, of people that said thank you. When a person says thank you, it means he understands that the Creator is doing the best thing in the world for him, even though it may be painful, might be unpleasant. What happens when you say thank you? It means that you believe that the Creator is doing everything for the best. And that's a declaration of a faith. And from that declaration of faith, it enables you to have a vessel to receive the divine abundance. There's two phases of faith. The first, that there's no one but the Creator. The second, that everything he does is for the best. And when you know these two things, you don't blame anybody else for whatever's going on in your life. And one of the difficult problems that a person that lacks emunah is he's all the time persecuting himself and he's blaming himself for what goes in his life and he's never happy Because he's not happy with himself, so he's certainly not happy with others, and he can't get along with other people. That's what we've said. There's no one but him. And this is emuna. When you can say, this is what the Creator wants. This is what the Creator wants. And the second thing, to know that everything is for the good. So if you don't believe that everything is good, you have to start singing. I don't understand a thing. I just believe that everything is for the best. I don't understand a thing. I don't understand a thing. I only believe everything's for the best. Thank you, Creator, for everything you do. Thank you, Creator, for the emunah that you give me. Thank you, Creator. If you don't understand, just say thank you. If the Israelites were in Egypt and they had emunah, then there wouldn't have been exile. It's not that I'm saying, it's in the Torah. The Torah is not a book of stories. It's not a history book. If somebody learns the Torah to learn history, what he writes on in the synagogue over the Holy Ark where the Torah scroll is, the history library, that's not right. Have to know that every word in the Torah is your own personal biography. It's about you. It's not something to know what happened way back 3,000 years ago about the salvation back then and the redemption back then. That if the Israelites in Egypt would have said thank you, they would have seen redemption immediately. So somebody says, how can you say something like that? So it says in the Torah that the Creator said to Abraham, our forefather, you should know that your offspring will be exiled in Egypt. The Creator said they're going to be exiled for 400 years. He told that to Abraham. And the Vayechi portion of Genesis, Rashi says,
why is this
particular portion difficult to understand? Because since Jacob died, then his sons, they were closed, the gates of spiritual understanding, because Jacob was complete emunah. When Jacob was alive, that had emunah. When did the exile start? When Jacob died. But it's a mistake. But it's not true, because when Jacob died, Joseph was still alive. And Joseph was his son who continued in the way of emunah. Joseph didn't sit in jail. So how can you sit there? That Joseph was a 17 years
old.
What did Joseph do in jail for 13 years? He was singing. He was singing to the Creator. Thank you, Creator. Thank you that I'm in jail. He said thank you to the Creator for being in jail. He lived his emunah. He knew that everything was for the best. How can it be for the best? He didn't understand. don't understand the thing. I don't understand the thing. Only believe that everything is for the best. Joseph, he didn't understand what the Creator was doing, but he believed it was all for the best. So the commander of the jail, the warden of the jail, he sees this prisoner, and he's singing and dancing. He says, come here, he liked this. He said, this guy, he didn't see anybody like that. He says, hey, come here, you're going to be my second in command. I'm going to give you authority here. And so what happened is that Joseph, in the end, he didn't sleep with the other prisoners. He didn't eat with the other prisoners. He had to be there, but he didn't live the life of a prisoner. Plenty of times I go to prisons in Israel to give lessons. And I teach the inmates, if you've got emunah, then you're really not in prison, because your soul is free. When I ever go to prisons, and every prison I go to, I have.
I have four
of my own students that I taught them how to teach in the jails. And they tell me stories about what happens to prisoners. And one of my students told me that it was in the synagogue in the prison synagogue. And you see, prisoners, the guys, they were thieves on the outside. And they come in, they learn about emunah, and they sit all day long, and they want to pray and learn Torah all day long. I have quite a few students that go to the prisons all over Israel, and they teach people. Now you can see what happens to the inmates. They learn emunah, and instead of being on the rock pile, they sit and learn Torah all day long. They pray all day long, and they're living a good life within the prison. But you see, his body's in a prison, but he himself is not in prison. His mind is not in prison because he has emunah now. And it's written in the Bible that the brothers saw that Jacob died, and they thought that Joseph was going to take revenge on them for selling them. How could they say that? Joseph has emunah. You know, his brothers didn't sell him down in slavery. That the father did. So if the brothers would have known Joseph, they would have learned from emunah. And they would have said thank you. And they wouldn't have become slaves in Egypt. They would have stayed in Egypt until the Creator decided to redeem them and bring them to the land of Israel, but they wouldn't have been slaves. That they would have nullified all the bad in the world. As soon as a person says thank you, he has his own personal salvation, his own personal redemption. This big rabbi in Israel didn't have children. And he did everything, every spiritual ploy, every doctor, every fertility treatment. So they finally came to Rabbi Arush and asked him what to do. And he said to say thank you to the Creator, they don't have children. So he came home and his wife thought he was crazy. And he said, we've tried everything else, let's try this. We'll say thank you to the Creator, we don't have children. And in the end, they had children. Because as soon as a person says thank you, it shows that he has belief in the Creator. And belief in the Creator is a vessel to receive spiritual abundance. The Creator created us. And I told this morning I spoke to a yeshiva, and I asked the people that were learning Torah there, I said, what's your purpose in life? To learn Torah? What do you think? To repent? No, what do you think? They didn't know the answer. Guys that are sitting and learning Torah. And I said, your purpose in life is to get to know the Creator. And that's what we're doing down in this world, to get to know the Creator. And that's why a person has all the difficulties in this world, because by way of the difficulties, he gets to know the Creator. There are tremendous angels in the sky, and they see the Creator face to face, but they don't know Him. In order to get to know the Creator, a person has to come down to this world, because down in this world, you have to go through all the difficulties in life. And a person goes through everything in order to seek out the Creator. A person, if everything good in life, he doesn't seek the Creator. When he has difficulties, he seeks out the Creator. You have to understand the Creator is totally good and is a loving Father in heaven and just has everything good. So here, let's go back to the children of Israel in Egypt. So when was the redemption? Okay, so Moses, when he was 20 years old, he escaped Egypt, and for 60 years he was in Midian. Where was he for 60 years until he was at the burning bush? So what happened? All of a sudden, the children of Israel were yelling out to the Creator. And at the same time, Moses was a shepherd for his father-in-law. So what happened? They could have yelled 60 years before. They started praying 60 years before. But if instead of yelling out to the Creator, and they would have said thank you to the Creator, there wouldn't have been slaves at all. Okay, so as soon as they started calling out to the Creator, Moses was revealed to them. 60 years later, every single day, he would take Jethro's sheep out in the field. And one day, the Creator revealed himself to Moses in a burning bush. And he says, I want you to go redeem the children of Israel. And Moses argued with the Creator. He says, I'm not worthy. I'm not worthy. And after all the debates back and forth between Moses and Moses says to the Creator, the children of Israel won't believe that you sent me. Moses says to the Creator, he says, how can I get them out? They're not going to believe me. They're going to think I'm some crazy hippie or something. Imagine, what would you do if somebody came in this room and said, look, God revealed himself to me. He received himself to me, and I've got the word. And here I am, that I've got the word from above. I've seen the light. I'm coming to bring you God's word. You think he was crazy? This is what Moses said to the Creator. He said, they're not going to believe me. So the Creator says, what's that in your hand? He says, that's my rod. He says, throw it down on the ground. And he threw it down the ground. And it became a snake. And Moses was afraid of the snake. He was afraid of the snake. Moses said to God that they're not going to believe me. And so God said to Moses, throw your stick down, your rod down, and it turned into a snake. What's going on here? One of the elaborators, the biblical elaborators, explains. They heard me talking about the redemption, so they give me the first of the four cups, just like on Passover. They said that the second, third, fourth cup, they'll come a little by little too. So I'm going to make a blessing. We'll make a blessing in English too. Baruch ato Adonai Eloheinu Melech Olam Shakol Nia Bidvoro. Thank you, Creator, for putting us in such a nice generation with throwaway bottles and everything convenient, a beautiful world, electricity. Everything's nice, isn't it? What used to be in the old times, it wasn't like this. So what do we say? So the Creator said to Moses, he says, do you believe in me or you don't believe in me? So if you believe in me, why are you afraid of the snake? So it's written about Moses that he was a shepherd way in the deep in the desert. Why deep in the desert? He would go to the deepest deserts, places that the humans wouldn't even go. So why would he go to such faraway places? What's out there? Lions, bears. And the Creator says, why weren't you afraid out in the desert where all the lions and the bears? Because I gave you emunah. You said the children of Israel won't believe. Here, you're speaking to me. And a stick that turns into a snake. That all of a sudden you saw that you're... He who believes doesn't afraid. We have the Creator of the world. And he's going to bring us all the salvations. And see, I just showed you that if I leave you, you're not going to believe me either. And it says, I'm the one that gives emunah. And it says, I'm the one that gives the Israelites their emunah. So we see that Moses learned from the Creator. When he came back and he did tell them who they was, they did believe in him. Why? Because the Creator gave them emunah. And person has emunah has a sweet life, a good life. So anything that you lack in life, it's because you lack emunah. So where are you supposed to get emunah from? We just learned that emunah you get from the Creator. Everything you get only from him, from nowhere else. There's no one but him. If you want emunah, ask the Creator. Hashem, give me emunah. Hashem, give me emunah like you gave to Moses. Moses said, they won't believe in me, but they did believe me. Why did they believe in me? Because I'm the one that gave them emunah. So they would believe in me. So if you want emunah, then ask the Creator. Father in heaven, give me emunah. Every person thinks, has to know.
Emunah
is synonymous to saying thank you. Emunah, full and complete emunah, is saying thank you. There's so many stories of people that played and prayed and prayed and prayed and nothing happened. But then the people said thank you and boom, right away got whatever they wanted. Everybody believes, and everybody believes in the Creator. And they believe that everything is Creator, and they believe that they have to pray, but they don't believe that everything the Creator does is for the best. They think that the Creator is doing bad. Look what happens when if a person doesn't say thank you, he prays. Suppose he needs a soulmate. And he says, Creator, give me my soulmate. Okay, I'm not talking, I'm just giving an example. I'm not talking. All right, imagine a person that doesn't have a soulmate, and he says to the Creator, look, Heavenly Father, you're not being fair with me. And up till now, the right way to do is to say, okay, Creator, if you didn't give me my soulmate up till now, then and I know that's the best for me. So first thing you have to do is to say thank you. Say thank you for your apparent disadvantage. And then only after you say thank you do you ask for what you need. I put together a song. Yesterday I wrote it. I wrote 8 verses yesterday. If you give me or don't give me, I'll always say thank you. Da, 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 da. If you give me or don't give me, I'll always love you. Die, 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 die. If you give me or don't give me, I'll always say thank you. Die, 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 die. If you give me or don't give me, I'll always love you. So what I say, whether or not you give me, I'm still going to say thank you because I believe that everything you do is for the best. And I believe you're a loving Father and I believe everything's going to do and I love you unconditionally. Master of the world, I love you unconditionally. Master of the world, you love everyone. You are so merciful. And you give all everybody a free gift. Master of the world, show me the way to talk to you each day and have a good start and love you with all my heart. If you give me or don't give me, I'll always love you. Die, 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 die. If you give me or don't give me, I will love you. Die, 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 die. If you give me or don't give me, I'll always say thank you. Die, 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 die. If you give me or don't give me, I'll always love you. Oh, but we're only talking about material. But when a person, has a spiritual request, don't say if you give me or don't give me. A spiritual request, the Creator has to give you. I want you to learn this mindset. Because there's no greater wisdom than emunah. Okay, you think of
the
belief.
It's
good. No, but it's a deep, deep knowledge. But anyway, if it's so simple, anybody could say, oh, I've got emunah already. And I told you that the most important thing, a person comes here to attain emunah. For years I've been giving lessons on emunah, and I've written quite a few books on emunah, on all phases. And for more than a decade, I have people that come to me and learn lesson after lesson. Because that emunah is deep, there's so much to learn. But I'm going to teach you a new mindset. And it will help you learn emunah. I have a brand new book. It's called The New Light. It's not yet translated because it's brand new. Yeah, the translators can't catch up to me. Okay, the book, I said thank you, and I saw salvation. Okay, yep. God willing, we'll be finishing that very soon, and you can see that being out in English very shortly. Okay, learn a new mindset. You have to know. A believer has to know that the Creator loves him, that the Creator's love for him or her is unlimited, infinite. A person can't understand how much a Creator loves him. Because we can only understand limited, finite things. We're humans. And we can't even understand, we can't feel the Creator's love because it's infinite. Everything the Creator does is infinite. His love for each person is infinite. Infinite love. The Creator gives us. Here's the next cup. I bless the entire congregation.
That
anybody that's lacking the soulmate gets their soulmate right now, right now. I bless this blessed congregation that everyone who's married, they should have real marital peace.
Amen.
And I bless everyone that everyone should have good fertility and wonderful children. And now, so everybody here, soon you'll be married if you're not yet married, you'll be parents if you're not yet parents. And you believe it, and that's the way it's going to be. And I'm giving you another blessing very soon. Okay, little by little, we still got time together. I've come all the way from Israel, I got a white beard, I got time. I was in a traffic jam. And the driver was getting nervous. And I told the driver, I said, be patient, you should have patience. Sablanut. Patience, sablanut.
Sablanut.
You have patience. There's nothing like patience. If you want to come close to the Creator, then you need a lot of patience. Because it takes time to get what you want. Have patience, having patience. Nothing's like patience. You should have patience and patience. Nothing like patience. I said, but there's emuna behind our songs, but we didn't just come here to sing. Amen. We bless everybody become parents soon. Amen. Every father, imagine that you're a parent, if you're not yet a parent. Okay, I can speak like a father. And the same thing as a mother. What does a father and mother want to give a children? Everything. More than everything. More than everything. What do they want to give the children? Everything. Not only in material, but in spiritual also. A father wants his son or daughter to have wonderful characteristics. Be patient, not angry, be happy all the time, have joy in life. This is what every parent wants for the child. Where do we get this love for our children? The love that we have for our children is something that comes natural. It's a light from the Creator that He gives us. You have to understand that the love between a husband and wife is not natural. You have to work on that. They say in Hebrew, if it's love at first sight, then it's divorce at second sight. I like when there's translation because you get different roles of laughter. I was in Paris. And I told a joke, and people aren't laughing. So I'm saying, what happened? It turned out the good translator was rolling with laughter, so he couldn't translate it. Okay, if we made an intermission. Okay, an artist made an exhibit, but nobody came. And one person finally came. And he looked at the artist's paintings. He says, tell me the truth. He says, what are you most impressed by the pictures? He says, the most surprising is how you could sell something like this. We learned that a love for a child is natural, a love for a spouse is not natural. The Creator enabled you to write three books on marital peace. Anybody who wants marital peace has to read the man's manual and a separate manual for women. Because each person, why separate book for men and women? Because every person has to do his or her own job in a marriage. And our sages say that finding a soulmate is more difficult than splitting the Red Sea. It means it's above nature. It's not only just finding the soulmate, it's every single day after the marriage. Every single day that a husband and wife is together, the Red Sea splits. And so that the Red Sea splits, you need a lot of prayer. I say all the time to people that you have to pray every day to have marital peace. in order to know the mindset for marital peace and to pray. Because love for a husband and wife is work, but love for a child, it's natural. Why did the Creator do it that way? In order to understand how He loves us, because He's our Father in heaven. Just like you want to give your own child everything good in the world, that's what the Creator wants to give you. Everything good in the world. That's the ABCs of Emunah. That you believe that the Creator loves you, infinite love, and He wants to give you everything. A person says, okay, if He loves me, then why did He give me? I can't give my kids, but He could give me. But just as there are material laws in the material world, there's laws in the spiritual world. One of the laws in the spiritual world, that the Arizal writes that if a person gets something without prayer, it's detrimental. Why is it detrimental if you get something without prayer? Because a person becomes arrogant. If he gets things without prayer, then he gets arrogance in his heart. And when a person is arrogant, then the Creator leaves him because he can't be with an arrogant person. Our sages say that the Creator and the arrogant person can't be in the same universe together. Because the Creator can't stand an arrogant person. So if a person's arrogant, he says he's not going to have a good life. Because he's not going to have the Creator with him. Here, now just understand, just like there's a vessel for material, there's for spiritual. See, I have a cup here, and the cup holds water. If there's not a cup here, the water is going to spill on the floor. And just as like in this material world, there's a vessel, a receptacle. You have to have a receptacle for abundance in the spiritual. Rabbi Nachman of Breslov writes that the words of prayer are receptacles for receiving divine abundance. Every word of prayer converts into a receptacle for divine abundance. And so the Creator wants us to have everything good, so it doesn't hurt us, it's not detrimental. So we're going to learn right now how to build the proper receptacle so that you could get abundance. In my yeshiva, there was a young man that learned. He was a nice guy, sweet, married with three kids. And he was a shy, sweet guy. But he got the first prize in the Irish lottery. No. He didn't get money. I'm not talking about money. I know this guy. I'm talking about something that his luck turned around. He lost his wife. He got divorced. He lost his kids. So what happened? So he was married. And he won the lottery. And how did he lose his family? He won a couple of $1 million. But they went crazy from it. And he ended up losing his wife, losing his kids. Why? What happened? Because he got all this money with no prayer.
לכן, בורא עולם רוצה לתת לנו הכל. הכל רוצה לתת לנו.
The Creator wants to give us everything.
לבנות כלים.
But we have to build spiritual vessels.
עם כלים שנוכל לקבל את הדברים לברכה.
But we have to build, why build the spiritual vessels? So we get the abundance with a blessing. To get that $1 million without a blessing, that doesn't help.
אז עוד פעם, נחזור. א',
Okay, let's review. First thing, that the Creator has infinite love for you. Second, that the Creator wants to give you everything, everything good in life. So what happens? So you come and ask for it. Okay, in spiritual, you have to say, if he gives me or if he doesn't give me, then it's fine, but not in spiritual. That the Creator this very minute could give you everything in spirituality. If you want emunah, this second he can give it to you. You want a joy in life, this minute he could give it to you. Anything that is spiritual, the Creator could give you this very moment. If you believe that you can't live without this, and you ask the Creator, I say, but if you think, okay, if he doesn't give me, the Creator doesn't give me emunah, all right. No big deal. No, but that's not the way to get it in spiritual. You have to feel that you can't live without it. And there's a law that says that the way a person goes, that is the way he is led. The way a person wants to go, that's the way that they lead him from above. So it means that if a person wants emunah, has a strong desire for emunah, that the Creator is going to give it to him. So if you have a spiritual request, you have to ask with all your heart, Master of the world, I want to get close to you, give me emunah. Help me speak to you every day. I can't live without this. I can't live without being close to you. Okay, so as soon as the Creator sees that you really want it, then you're going to get it. But you have to pray with a full and complete desire, a true desire, and you have to get it. You can't live without emunah. You can't live without prayer. It's such a gift. What a gift it is. When a person can talk to your Creator whenever he wants. And I always say, a person who believes, he talks to the Creator. A person that doesn't talk to the Creator doesn't believe. Why? Why? A person says, okay, I believe in God, but I don't talk to him. But I say, if you believe, then you speak to him. I get in the car, and I say, thank you to the Creator that I have a car. And I pray to the Creator, Master of the world, help me get to my destination safely. Because I believe in him. And I believe his help to get from one. I need his help to get from one place to another. A person has to live this emunah. Everybody that's sitting here has to say thank you to the Creator for your chair. If you don't want to say thank you to the Creator, get up. Say thank you. Say thank you for the chair. Why take the chair for granted? I said thank you for the water. Thank you for the microphone. Thank you for electricity. We see, we hear. Let's do breathing exercises. Everybody take a deep breath. Thank you, Master of the world, for every breath I take. Thank you for the health you give us. Everything, we have to say thank you. We have to ask for everything.
לפני שנכנסתי לפה, התפללתי. וגם כשעמדתי פה, התפללתי. אפילו שאני
יודע את הכל, here,
כבר שלימד אותי. אפילו. כל דבר מתפללים.
We have to thank for everything.
אתה הולך לבית, אתה הולך לכיוון הבית, אז תבקש אבא שבשמיים.
You go to the direction of the house.
לכבד את אשתי, לאהוב אותה, להגיד לה מילים יפות. אבא שבשמיים, תעזור לי לשמח את אשתי. אשתה גם צריכה להתפלל.
Have to ask for everything. You're coming home from work and you have to say, Master of the world, help me make my wife happy. Before you walk in the house, Master of the world, help me smile at her. Master of the world, help me have peace at home. You have to say thank you for everything. You have to pray all the time. Ask for every little thing. It all comes to the Creator. If somebody, if you spend the day with me, you laugh. I wash my hands. I say thank you to the Creator for the water. But it's that thank you for everything. But no, that's not funny. The funny thing is when you don't say thank you. Because a person that has emunah, he lives the presence of the Creator with every breath he takes. And that's what King David said. King David says that with every breath, he says this in Psalm 150. So every breath he praises the Creator. A nuance. I want to tell you. In the course of a person's life, a person has a path in life. Every person has his own path in life. And the Creator takes each person along his own path in life. But on his path, there's ups and there's downs. And there's bump holes. Potholes in the path in life. It's not smooth. But imagine somebody says, the person guy lives in Tel Aviv says, you got to get to Jerusalem. But so Jerusalem, it's way up on a mountain, and there's the Holy Temple. And beautiful thing. And you know that you want to go to Jerusalem, you have to ascend. Okay. So he wants to go to Jerusalem. So he starts going to Jerusalem. And all of a sudden, he sees a big descendant, a descent. And he's got to go down the mountain. He says, wait a second. This is, I must be on the wrong path. But I'm going to get to Jerusalem. He told me the way is up. They say, yeah, Jerusalem, it's high, but on the way to that high, there's hills, there's valleys, there's delays. And that's a parable for life. Yeah, you want to go up in life, but you have to know that the way is full of ups and downs. And delays and difficulties. And you have to learn from every one of these situations. And this we have to learn that each person has his own path in life with his own ups and downs, his own difficulties. And sometimes in the descent, there's darkness. But you have to know within the darkness, there's big light. How do you see the light within the darkness? How do you turn on the light switch within the darkness? Where do you find? You say thank you. Once you say thank you for your difficulty in life, then all of a sudden your difficulty becomes illuminated. And you see how it's for the best. So that way, you say thank you to the Creator. Thank you, Hashem, that things are hard for me. Thank you that I have difficulties in life. Thank you that I have anxiety. Thank you that I'm worried. Start saying thank you. And this put on the button that illuminate your life. And say thank you many times. When you say thank you within the darkness, and you believe that the Creator is with you in the darkness, and He's going with you, that the light of the Creator is with you, this illuminates your darkness. And say thank you. The Creator wants to bring you close to Him. So thank you, Master of the world, if I have darkness in my life. I say thank you. See the light within the darkness. Because every thank you say, it lights a candle of emunah in your soul. It lights a candle, you get another candle of faith, and your soul is illuminated. We have a prayer we say every Rosh Hashanah and every Saturday night. But we ask the Creator to open up the various gates, the gates of income, gates of happiness, gates of emunah. And these are the gates. So if you want to open up all the gates, you have to do what King David said in Psalm 100, is to open up the gates of gratitude. Say, if you want a good income, say thank you to the Creator. Thank you, Creator, that up till now I had difficulty in making a living. Thank you, Creator, that the money doesn't come easy. And by saying thank you, you make a vessel for more abundance. That's why I said thank you for the cup, because with the cup I can get water. It's not silly to say thank you. It's silly not to say thank you. Because this instills in our heart the full and complete faith every single moment, from not just the big things, but even the little things in life. Okay, so suppose once again with the example of income. If you lack income, first of all, thank the Creator that up to now you had something to eat, you had something to wear. Thank you for what you have, first of all. Because I think like this, and everything is a gift from the Creator. I don't deserve a thing. I don't deserve a thing. I don't deserve, I don't deserve, I don't deserve a thing. The Creator doesn't owe me a thing. He doesn't think, thank you very much, Master of the world, for all what you do for me. Thank you very much, Master of the world, for everything you do that you do for me. I don't understand the thing. I don't understand the thing. I don't understand. Only believe. Only believe that's all for the good. I don't understand a thing. I don't understand a thing. Okay, we got to say thing and say thank you to the Creator. How do you open up the gates of abundance? There's a key to open up all the gates. What's that key? It's thank you. Gratitude is the key that opens up all the gates. You need good health? And we've had stories, a lot of people that suffered from terminal diseases, the worst terminal diseases. I can tell you plenty of stories. And a person that said thank you for their terminal disease, and they were cured. And you're going to tell us more of your stories, and we'll write another book.
Mama.
I sing like this.
It's a
either emunah or I lose my mind. Person without emunah, it goes crazy, loses his mind. Rabbi Nachman Breslev says, that thank you.
Lama. Bon gidak him lama. Lama toda zerfu ashlema. Ki Adam Bish Abinahman Breslev Amar. כל המחלות הם בגלל קלקול השמחה.
Rabbi Nachman says that all disease is because a person loses his joy in life. If a person is happy, then he doesn't have any diseases. And not material diseases, not spiritual diseases. When a person says thank you, so what does thank you mean? Thank you means you're happy with your lot in life. What's a person that's happy with his lot in life? He's happy with his particular circumstance. With their lot in life. What's it mean, your lot in life? It means that all your life, everything that happens to you, the favorable and the seemingly unfavorable, this is all your lot in life. And when you say thank you, it means that you know that the Creator is with you. And that your lot in life, that's everything. Everything is for the good. Hashem Tov Tamid. Good. There's no bad in the world. Die. The Creator is always good. He is always good. There's no bad in the world. Die. The Creator is good. Everything He does is wonderful. So if you're happy with your lot in life, it means that you're happy with the Creator. And even when it's difficult in life, say the Creator, thank you. Thank you, Father in Heaven, that things are tough on me. Thank you. First thing, say thank you. And then ask. Because when you say thank you, this will give you joy in life. And you say thank you a couple of times and you'll see, you'll still get joy in life. It works. Because thank you is a vesicle, is a
vehicle.
Thank you is that whole and complete receptacle for receiving the abundance of emunah. Well, you believe that your joy in life you get from the Creator. And if you're not happy, it means that the Creator closed your faucet. So how do you open your faucet? Say thank you to the Creator. And you open up, everybody say thank you. So I started to explain to you that thank you is health. Thank you is good healing. It's easily understandable how physical health depends on gratitude. Because when a person is thank you, he's in a good mood. And it's good for his heart. And if it's good for his body, it's certainly good for his soul. People that were on psychiatric meds, and plenty of these people come to me. And I said, if you believe me and do what I'm going to tell you to, then you're going to be healthy, emotionally healthy, and you won't need pills. And you can get rid of them. You have to know that the soul and emunah are one aspect. They're one entity. So anything a soul suffers from is a problem in emunah. Any difficulty in the soul, any sickness in the soul, is a difficulty in emunah. So if you correct your emunah, then you correct your soul. So everybody's insane. Everybody's sick in their soul. Excuse me.
Okay.
People are full of anxiety. They're full of fear. They're full of depression. And what? Anger. A person, angry person. He's not insane. He's not sick in his soul. So everybody in a certain degree is sick in their soul. Hey, so don't you, if you want to be healthy in your soul, then you have to learn emunah. And that's, you have to remember, that's why you came to this world, in order to learn emunah. And this is your mission in life. This is what you have to do in this world, to learn emunah. And to ask for more emunah. How do you do it? You learn the books and the booklets. You listen to emunah CDs. People told me that they started reading emunah books and they became happy and healthy in their souls. By emunah.
Emunah.
A person that lives in emunah, that the Creator loves him, he doesn't have any worries. He believes that whatever happens, this is all for the best. And whatever happens in his life is all for the best. Because it all comes from the Creator. And it's a result of the Creator's unlimited love for him. The Creator is completely good. He created you because he wants to do good for you, so you can have a beautiful life. It's emunah or purgatory. It's Ibrahim Emunah or purgatory. It's emunah.
היום גם כתבתי היום כמה בתים, אבל כתבתי גם כמה בתים.
I wrote 70 verses. Don't look for who's to blame.
ככה רוצה השם.
Because this is what the Creator wants.
זה חדש, רק כתבתי. תחפש מי השם.
Don't look for someone to blame. Because this is what the Creator wants. See, receive everything with emunah. That you should always be happy.
Thank you, Creator.
Thank you. Everybody say thank you to Creator. Thank you to Creator.
Gracias, Hashem.
Gracias. Everybody say thank you in your language.
Gracias, Hashem, por todo lo que nos das. Gracias, Hashem.
Thank you, Hashem, for everything you do.
לאט לאט אני אלמד את כל השפות, נראה לי. זאת השם, אני... Thank you, Hashem. Thank you, Hashem. טוב, Hashem. Merci beaucoup, Hashem. Spasiba, Hashem. Gracias, Hashem.
Thank you, Hashem.
Danke, Hashem. במרוקאית אין מילה תודה.
In Moroccan, there's no word for thank you.
אין מילה תודה, אתם יודעים למה?
You know why?
הייתי כמה פעמים במרוקו.
I was a couple of times in Morocco.
באמת, באמת. תן חיוך.
He could give a smile.
תן חיוך. תקשיב, תכף אני אגיד לכם במרוקאית מה זה.
I'll tell you in a minute, in Moroccan, what's thank you. Nothing like patience.
סבלנות.
Be patient.
במרוקאית אין מילה תודה, אני... הייתי כמה פעמים במרוקו.
Why is there no word for thank you in Morocco?
המרוקאים רק ברכות. לאקטר חירק, לאטק פרחה,
Blessings. Everything is blessings. Blessings. They don't say, thank you, they bless you. When you want to say thank you, you bless somebody. Blessings after blessings after blessings. The word shukran is in Arabic, it's not Moroccan. But it's only blessings, blessings, blessings.
Did
you want to say thank you to somebody? You say, Hashem should give you good health, Hashem should give you strength. And Moroccan, that's only... Thank you is a blessing.
So,
we explain. And I want you to understand. Don't be embarrassed. That every blessing comes from emunah. And every bad characteristic comes from heresy. Good character comes from emunah. Emotional sickness comes from heresy, the opposite of emunah. I imagine arrogance. Okay, what does a person have to be arrogant about? Okay, the Creator takes away his oxygen. There, this is balloon burst. What do you got to be so arrogant about?
Okay.
If a person is angry, in Moroccan it's mabul, it's an idiot. But the person's miserable. A person is angry, what is he lacking? Life? He's lacking emunah. That any bad character trait, it's insanity. But a person that's healthy and is old, patience, everything is good. It's everything, and this is what says. This is what Hashem wants. This is what Hashem wants. So if you want to be emotionally healthy, okay, so if you have emunah, you live in paradise. With emunah, a person lives in paradise. Without emunah, a person lives in purgatory. The person that doesn't have emunah, he goes crazy, he's insane, loses his mind. We came to this world in order to attain emunah. So you should learn. In Israel, I was in a school, and the principal of the school is a student of mine, and he bought 600 books regarding emunah for young people that distribute amongst the students. And the students started learning the Garden of Emunah for young people. It's asked that I should give a lesson to the teachers. I taught the teachers. So I said to the teachers, okay, the fact that you teach kids Torah, that's wonderful. But if he gets an iPhone, and then he's going to leave the Torah in 5 minutes. But if he learns emunah, then he'll never. As soon as a person learns emunah, then he's going to live his life with Hashem.